blessed. It was a blessing in disguise because we were really sad to leave our ward. But we got into our new ward and they have just loved us. The 13th ward has just loved us and served us incredibly. And one of the amazing things that was done, sorry, it always chokes me up, this last October, they did a room makeover for my mom, a mini home makeover for her. And they redid her room and they found the perfect shade of yellow. She always talked about that she wanted the perfect shade of yellow, and Camille was able to find the perfect shade of yellow. And did her room in daisies. If you notice, there's a lot of daisy things. She loved her daisies. And the service that was given by the ward was so humbling for Mom and I, and pretty much from the Boy Scouts to the High Priest. We had Boy Scouts and Cub Scouts pulling weeds. We had High Priests and other men building things, building headboards. We had little kids helping build and paint the headboard. We had women and their daughters come in and organize our scrapbooking room. And for any of you who've been in our home, know that that's a huge undertaking because my mom was kind of a flutter horse. But so many people came into our home and served us. And because of their service, they were able to be touched by Patti and by her smile. And I've had so many people tell me that she was able to inspire them. And it brings a lot of joy in my heart to know that in her last days, she was able to leave a legacy of happiness and leave a legacy of love. And it was because of the board members who were so willing to reach out to us and to share and to give so much, your time and talents to us. Just really, really bright her life. And just every morning she would wake up and she was happy. And we now find comfort and happiness in that room and think of all of the ward members who served and loved us so much. And my mom also had a very spiritual side. She was a very private person and a very quiet person, but she was also very spiritual and had a very good, deep love for the scriptures and a very deep love for the Savior. And I truly believe that when we are in the service of our fellow beings, we are in the service of our God, and she felt that very, very much. I know that she had a testimony of the historic gospel. She just knew it was true. There was no wavering in her mind. She had many special experiences that she shared, just kind of tidbits with us here and there, but she knew that the Book of Mormon was the Word of God, and it brought her peace and happiness. And that's an important legacy I want all the grandkids to know, that their grandma loved Heavenly Father and loved Jesus Christ. And it's wonderful that she can be with them now. And I want you all to know that that's a legacy that she left to you, her testimony.
In closing, we just want to say that we know now that Mom is with her loved ones that have preceded her. She's with Heavenly Father and Jesus, and that she's now finally truly happy, Patti, running and jumping, and out of this body that she had here on this earth. And now she's so glad to see Dad again. She was so mad at him for leaving her. How dare he leave her like that? And we love her. We miss her, we'll miss her every day, and we know that we'll see her again. We're so grateful that she and Dad were buried in the temple, that we can be a family forever. And I want to thank you all for being here. We love you all. We feel your love.